design customer experience. And I'll give you some guiding principles on designing a customer experience strategy. We'll keep this talk short, and towards the end, we can take questions and answers. You know what? Many years ago, when I started into this user experience design area, people used to ask me, what do you do? Anybody outside of my professional network, I had to spend lots of time explaining what is user experience design. I still do some amount of explaining, but the awareness is much more now. The same is with customer experience. It is at that same level of emergence where it has to be made understood. You have to explain what's customer experience. So what do you think? Is user experience and customer experience all the same? Yes? No? They're not. Actually, they're different. And what is the difference? Let us take an example. We'll take in, let's say this is about Ram. He wants to file his income tax return online. So Ram does a Google search and finds, say, abc.com, and he has to go and file his income tax return there. So he's able to find the site very quickly because the search engine optimization was implemented very well. He can look at the details that he wants to look for because probably the information architecture, the taxonomy, the interaction is designed very well. He is able to complete his desired task of finding the information in a couple of clicks over a period of time. He is happy with that. Now he has a doubt and he is getting confused to fill up the lengthy form online. So he searches for a customer rep number and decides to call the customer rep executive. So okay, when he calls, he goes to the interactive voice recorder, fills his option, and there's a long musical hold, 15 minutes to get to the customer rep. Sounds familiar? He asks his query, the rep is unable to answer it, and the rep says, I'll go back to my manager and answer this for you, can I put you on hold? Another hold. In the meantime, the call drops off. Now, what next? He has to call up the same number again, go through the entire process again, speak to a new customer rep and solve his problem. So when you look at this example, the user experience with the application is fine. Ram is happy with that. But the overall customer experience he is facing in getting his task done is less than satisfactory. Similarly, if you look at another example, let's say a cab booking example. In the previous presentation, we mentioned that. So if the cab booking example just limited to the mobile app, if you have a WOW mobile app, is that enough? That's not, because the experience extends beyond that. So on-time arrival of the cab, the attitude of the driver, the condition of the cab, the etiquettes of the driver, everything is important for you to feel happy about the entire experience. Not only that, even the payments and the billings, if you have any complaints, how do you connect with your customer service cell there, everything. So it's the holistic experience that's really important. And that is what will help you decide whether you will again go with the same brand, you will recommend it to your family or friends, or you will not. And that is the difference. User experience focuses on the interactions a person has with a product or a service. Customer experience focuses on all the interactions that person has with the brand. It's a holistic, cumulative, across channels experience which are seamlessly connected, not just disjoint. Yep. So, in essence, it's the customer experience that determines whether an individual who is likely to become a potential customer will continue to stay as a customer or will recommend it to other friends and family. And this is across all channels, be it web, be it mobile, call center, vouchers, anything and everything. Before we get to the customer experience strategy part of it, there are a couple of questions that everybody will have in their mind. Are users and customers the same personas? Why do we need a customer experience strategy? How is it different from a brand strategy? So are users and customers same? Is it same? Anybody?
Not necessarily.
Yeah, not necessarily. Especially in a B2B context, in an enterprise context, they are definitely different. A customer in a B2B context is a buyer who helps with the buy decision. They will tell the organization whether you should buy this product or not. While the user is who actually uses the product. They're two different personas, so you will design different journeys for them. In a B2C context, it depends. For example, if you are booking an airline ticket for yourself and you are traveling, you are the customer and you are the user. But if you're a parent and you're making a decision to buy a toy for a kid, the parent becomes a customer and the kid becomes a user. Now, there could be a variation to this. There are a few detergent companies which are targeting the kid as a person who will influence the parents to buy the detergent. That's another scenario. So basically, customers and users are different. But when I talk about customer experience here, for this presentation, we'll assume they are the same and we'll proceed. Why do we need CX strategy? Because we are living in experience economy. Customers are not buying products or services, they buy the experience they get with the product or services. So the CX strategy becomes really important. Is there a difference between a brand strategy and a customer experience strategy? No, there's only one strategy for a business. And every other strategy, be it customer strategy, product strategy, is derived from your brand strategy. Strategy is always singular. For example, what is the strategy for Apple? They don't tell their customers that they sell phones or computers. They sell experiences. For them, the USP is the wow in design. It's user-friendliness, it's intuitiveness. If you look at Disney, they don't sell their customers that they sell tickets for a theme park or they create animations. They sell experiences. They are in the business to entertain the family. So they say we are in a family entertainment business. It's not important what you do, it's how you do it. And BMW, similar, the ultimate driving machine, it's much more than a slogan. It is in the design practices. It is ultimate driving machine. So welcome to a few guiding principles that will help you create a customer experience strategy. You basically start with a vision. You will define the intended experience that your customer will have with your product and service. This is across all the channels, across all multiple touch points. You'll have multiple journeys, identify the key journeys, and define the experiences you want your customers to have with the product and service. The most important factor, you need to understand your customers. You need to know who your customers are, how they are interacting with the brand today, if they are, or if it's a new launch, then this question is irrelevant, and what they want and need in future. This is the key to get the experience right. And with this, basically, the product strategy will also come in place, where you have the business segmentation, your customer segmentation, your prioritization, what should go first in the market. Everything becomes very important and relevant. Once you understand the customers, you can derive the pain points that they see in the whole process, and you can define and design the solutions around it. Design is not what it looks or feels like, it's basically how it works. So if you look at an iceberg, all you see is the tip of an iceberg. That's, for example, your visual design or your look and feel. But a lot of work goes below that. So 80% of work happens actually to get to where you are. Strategy is the bottom part here, where you define your strategy and business need. Then you have your functional spec, your channel definition, your touch points definition. Then you develop your interaction design, information architecture. Come up with your interface design, your navigation design, and then comes your visual design or the interaction that you see with the product or the service. So this is the key. And I will not touch base much on this because you all are from the design field. You know how it has to be done. So apply the best practices there. Do what is the most critical and the important need for the customer. Weed out all the thing that's junk. Most important, test early, iterate often. And lastly, culture. You need to build a design culture into the organization. It's basically build customer centricity into the organization DNA so that everybody talks CX. It's not the people who just do it, but everybody in the organization. And obviously for any startup to be successful, you should have some governance and measurement practices. So I think that's about it. Any questions? You're good?